You are now tuned in to Fashion Talk Radio with the Danielle Baker. I am the owner and director of Signature Inc. Models and Company and the Girls Glam Fashion Program. What you know about me? Well, you can get familiar by following me on Twitter at the Danielle B. That's T-H-E-E Danielle B. Or you can befriend me on Facebook. I love new friends. You can find me on Facebook under the Danielle Baker. Today's show is all about living the full size plus size life. So models, makeup artists, wardrobe stylists, producers, agencies, photographers, or just ordinary people. Let's talk fashion. We have some wonderful guests in the studio with us today. They're just going to be celebrating their women of size, and we encourage men of size to call in today too. So if there's any men out there, men of size, you can definitely call us at 410-481-1010. So we're going to start off with our inspirational moment, and it's all about be who you are in your own skin. We're all fearfully and wonderfully made, says our God. So we want to make sure that we are living our life to the fullest and we're comfortable with the package that was delivered in our life. And these girls and these ladies here in front of me is definitely going to be giving us some of what they do. So I definitely want to introduce them to you. We have Miss Giovanna and we also have Miss Melinda. Hi, ladies.
Hi. How you doing?
Great. So what we're going to do right now, if y'all can tell me, based on our show today, we're going to start with Miss Giovanna. First of all, tell us who you are and what you do.
My name's Giovanna Reyes. I'm the owner and designer of Curvista. It's a website that we have online right now for plus size women, sizes 12 to 24.
Wow.
I'm also the founder of Fashion Night Out Plus, and we're doing our very first one at Beautiful Boutique this coming Thursday. For me, I've been to the Fashion Night Out in New York and Georgetown, and I was a little disappointed that the only plus size events during Fashion Night Out were with Ashley Stewart and Lane Bryant. Outside of that, out of the 95 stores in Georgetown, there was no one doing something for plus sizes that I know of.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe it wasn't advertised. So, this year, after Full Figure Fashion Week, where I debuted my line, I met a lovely woman, Camille Newman. She does Papa Plus in New York.
Mm-hmm.
And I met Camille Leverett of Beautiful Boutique. They just happened to be two Camille.
Now I got some questions for people that don't know. What's pop-up?
Pop-up, that's a temporary store that you open up for a period of time. It could be a day. It could be a month.
Gotcha.
She usually does it for about 2 weeks.
Okay.
And she's doing hers in September, September 28th, I believe. And I will be at the grand opening as well.
Oh, that's awesome.
So I met the two of them and I and met some wonderful vendors, Ear Candy, Juice of Ear Candy. Hey, girl. Nikki B Accessories. They're really big in the D.C. area. And we just decided to come together and do something exclusively for plus size.
Wow. And you're here from Virginia right now?
Yes, I'm from McLean.
Okay. So do you see any difference as far as styling or anything? Because you slid it in there that you have your own design. So you got to tell me about that.
Well, I owned a boutique when I lived in Atlanta. I've only been here for a year.
Okay.
And after sitting and not doing anything for 6 months and adjusting the children and the family, I just felt like it was time for me to launch my designs. They've been in my mind for so long. So I moved forward and I was accepted for the Full Figure Fashion Week.
That's
because I have a
awesome.
Limited amount. So, it was God's way of saying just go for it. And I did it. And with God's blessing, it was well received.
Wow. Well, I'm going to go ahead and put in my request now. We're going to be celebrating 10 years in fashion, Signature Inc. Models.
Oh, congratulations.
And thank you. And this coming March. So we're planning our 10th year anniversary fashion show now. So we would definitely want you to have some. All right. Look, put me on your calendar. We'll get in contact with you. Absolutely. And also, I'm going to go ahead and introduce Miss Melinda. Tell us what you do and who you are.
Hi, I'm Melinda. I just started Plus Size Modeling, I want to say about 2 years ago.
It hasn't been 2 years, because I'm going to tell you about you. It seemed like you fell out the sky. All of a sudden, you hear and see you everywhere, on every social media. You is tanning down. I'm like, where did this girl come from? But go ahead, two years.
You got to promote yourself.
Right.
That's one of the things I learned. You got to promote yourself. It's only been about 2 years. I started with B.I.G. by Jetta. My mother's girlfriend saw me one day. And Jetta does this plus size calendar.
Hey, Jetta. Shout out to Jada.
Yes, shout out to Jada, B-I-G. So my mom's girlfriend's like, you have to do this calendar. And I'm like, I don't want a model. I want to be a plus size stylist. I don't want a model. So she kept bugging me about it and bugging me about it. So then I went to meet Jada, and Jada was like, okay, we're going to try you out. So I went to, she did a fashion show, and she, I went to California with my son the very next week. She said, oh, you have your own solo part in the fashion show. And I'm like, oh my God, what am I going to do?
Aww.
And so ever since then, I've just been studying my craft, trying to get on my A game.
Wow, that is awesome. I definitely have some questions for y'all. I just want to say really quick that this show is sponsored by Capacity Boutique. Miss Kiana, me and her go way back. She always just there to help out and really, really do a great job with training models and styling models, and I believe we have her on the line, so I'm gonna try this out. Hey Kiana.
Hi Danielle.
Oh, welcome to Fashion Talk Radio. First of all, we want to thank you for sponsoring our show today. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Well, I'm Kiana Chinette of Capacity Boutique, plus size model for over 25 years.
Years.
I have a boutique that specializes in fashion for the curvy fashionista, size 8 to size 32.
All right. So where can we find more information about you or your boutique if we're looking for styling?
Well, I'm located at 4327 Harford Road on the second floor, right in the Lauderdale area in Baltimore.
Now, back to Miss Giovanna. I want to talk about, how was it growing up? As a curvy woman or a curvy girl, how was it growing up? Did that impact your, you know, your future? Did you have low self-esteem? Was there anything that you want to encourage somebody with?
Yeah, for me, I do come from a Latin background. My mom is Dominican. My dad is Puerto Rican. So
wow.
The women are naturally curvy,
uh-huh.
Especially on the Puerto Rican side. They just got hips like you wouldn't believe. But for me, I was always the tallest. My brother and I, we were always the largest ones in the entire family, generationally.
Wow.
So it was always different for us. And for me, I was just telling Melinda before we started that I did straight size modeling from the age of 14 till about 18.
Okay.
And really had a hard time keeping the weight down. I was 5'8", and I was 110 pounds, maybe max 125, and I was too big at 125.
Mm-hmm.
So did all the wrong things to try to stay thin. And it just wasn't natural for me. So when I went to college, I just became curvier because I stopped modeling. And during that time, they didn't have plus size modeling like they do now.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't an option for me. I didn't think it was an option, didn't know of it. So I look now and I say these women are so blessed because they have that opportunity that we didn't have 20 years ago.
Right. So. Wow. Is there anything that you want to say to anyone that's listening that may not be a model that's in the field but is a woman of size?
If they're interested. I say as a photographer, as a designer, when I book models, I look for, first of all, personality.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be gracious.
Yes.
You have to be humble.
Amen.
I'm humble. I'm humble when I walk in anywhere. I say thank you. I say, you know, good morning. You just have
to. Can you appreciate a little bit?
Exactly. You can have the most beautiful face, and I won't hire you if I feel like you're coming in like, I belong here. You can be confident, but just, I say that, have that humble spirit.
Right.
Because they have to work with you, the photographer, the makeup artist, the hairstylist. If my hairstylist and my makeup artist say, you know what, she was a real pain.
Mm-hmm.
I never work with that person.
Exactly.
Again. So it's important.
I can feel
personality
you
is important.
Absolutely.
Great skin, of course. Limit the amount of tattoos. You can have some tattoos, but if you're going into lifestyle and you really want to broaden your range nationally and internationally, limit the tattoos because that's an issue. If you do have them, let people know.
Right.
Okay. And height. Now they do petite modeling. They do
petite
plus. Jeannie Ferguson, petite model, 5'3". Mm-hmm. She's 5'3". She opened up for me for Full Figure Fashion Week and brought the house down.
Right.
So she's amazing.
But she wears 3-4 inches.
She does.
All right.
The walk.
Okay.
Like, there's no stopping it. She starts it and she ends it. That's all.
And she's
going to
be at Fashion Night Out Plus?
She will be at Fuller Woman Expo. If you're in the Detroit area, make sure you check that out. Fuller Woman Expo. That's the weekend, the 9th, 10th, and 11th.
Okay. I got family down there. I got to let them know. Okay.
Yeah, so, but for the models, I say, you know, have great skin. even if you're plus size, you do have to take care of yourself. Yes. Make sure, you know, you're tight.
Yes.
Right.
The whole thing.
Got you. Now, Miss Melinda, you got to tell us, how was it growing up as a curvy girl?
Well, as a curvy girl, I've always been, out of all my friends, the short, dark-skinned, chubby girl.
Did you have nicknames?
They used to call me Big B, only because I had big boobs.
Oh!
I was like in the second grade with a bra.
Really?
Really. Yeah. And so I've always been a curvy girl from day one. I was a big baby. I was a big middle schooler, elementary schooler, high schooler. But I've always loved to be fly.
Okay.
My father owned his own boutique, so he told me, if you're going to be a big girl, be a fly big girl. And I kept that with me. I had issues with being dark skinned because back in the day, nobody.
But look, she's a beautiful dog. I told you the first time I met you, I said, I love your skin.
Thank you.
I mean, it's flawless.
Thank you.
But it really is.
They used to tease me all the time. And my mother, I thank God for my parents because they always gave me that self-confidence. My mother said when I was younger, she remembers me in the bathroom trying to wash the black off of my skin.
Are you serious?
But she and my dad always encouraged me to be the best that I can be.
Right.
So, and after that day, I never had a problem.
Oh, my gosh. So it really impacted your self-esteem a lot?
It really impacted my self-esteem a lot. I did not like myself too. I was, like, in middle school. And then I said one day, well, I care what people say.
Wow.
Because I can only be the best me.
Right.
And then after that, once you start to like yourself, other people start
back to the inspirational moment.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
People start to see it. So then boys start to come. And
uh-oh.
I've always had friends, but you know, they be like, oh, you look pretty today. So,
and I know some guys that actually prefer curvier women than skinnier women.
And all of them might not admit it, but they all.
Yeah, cry. If you're one of those guys, call us at 410-481-1010. We want to hear from you. Wow. So also tell us about, I know you blogging now. What is Peacock all about? Okay. Tell us.
Actually, I just got my business name in the mail yesterday. So
congratulations.
Peacock is in full effect now. I will be blogging. I will be on your Facebook page.
All right.
I will be on your Twitter. You are going to know. Plus model Melinda Nicole.
Yes.
So I'm going to be everywhere. So if I hound you, just be on the lookout for me. Sorry, but got to promote myself.
It's coming out.
I decided to start the Fashion Peacock in January after I lost a very, very dear friend of mine. Her name was Danielle Peacock.
Her last name was Peacock?
Yes.
Okay. Well, her first name was Danielle?
Yeah, her first name was Danielle. Her last name was Peacock. I lost her to cancer.
Uh-huh.
And she was small, but she was the baddest chick I ever knew. She can dress, put wild stuff together. We used to do hair shows together. And I was always the background.
How old was she?
Danielle, she passed when she was 31 years old.
Oh, wow. 31 young.
31 years old. So after I was grieving really, really bad. And then I said, you know what? It's time for me to start my dream. It's time.
Mm-hmm. And how long ago was this?
She died December 28th.
Oh, you all right, Melinda? Because I'm about to reach across here and give you a hug. Give her a hug for me, Miss Giovanna. You all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
Okay. But no, but that's great. So you really started your business out of the love and care for your friend. So that's why you named it Peacock. All right. That is really good. And so also, let's talk about what right now Signature Inc. is in need of interns. So if you are under the sound of my voice and you are an intern, we are looking for people of skills, people that love fashion. You have to have a sense of fashion. We are looking for people that can be an assistant, people that's in marketing, backstage personnel and help, and also bloggers. So if that fits your description, please get in contact with us at 443-865-8318. That's 443-865-8318. Or you can actually email info@signatureinc.com and let us know what you're interested in. We have a caller online named Eugene. We definitely want to hear from a guy so that we can balance this out. Hi, Eugene.
Hello, ladies.
Hi, Eugene. Hello.
Hey.
How you guys doing?
Calling and represent for the guys.
I love curvy women.
Amen.
Oh, and that's one reason why I'm calling in. My wife, I hope she doesn't hear this because she's going to come home and beat me with
it. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, wifey.
Okay, first of all, I just walked in the door. I went to the mailbox, and I put some things in the mailbox, and I just found WOLB online, and so I mean, that's where I'm listening to you guys at.
Oh, amen.
Yeah, yeah. You know, that's two good things happened today.
Yes.
Okay, I'm blind.
Okay. Oh, really?
Okay, I have my own business.
Give me your contact information.
Well, I have a cafe in a federal building downtown,
okay.
The City Crescent building on the second floor. And most of my business comes from a captured audience, which are federal employees in that building, basically the Army Corps Engineer, HUD, and some other agencies. Okay, and but you know, I did this through the Department of Education and the Blind Enterprise Program, and who else? The DOORS, the Department of Occupational Rehabilitation Services. That's a mouthful.
Mm-hmm.
But I just wanted to say that this young lady, you sound passionate, and to be a business person, you have to be in love with what you're doing.
Right.
And that's what it sounds like you're doing. And I'm rooting for you.
Thank you.
Okay, and my friend who has a business, we just talk to each other. We say it's like living over top of the store. You never can get away from it, and you never want to get away from it.
Wow.
So I just want to encourage you to.
And I want to encourage you to, it's probably going to blow your mind, but we just did a fashion show June 25th. It was called Stare. Mm-hmm. And I did this to raise money for the visually impaired and the blind industries. And it's just very impactful for you to call in. That's why I said we need to get
thing.
Your information because, I mean, we did. We had a scene where we dedicated to all blind people where the mm-hmm. models walked mm-hmm. blindfolded. I mean, it was phenomenal. Mm-hmm. So if you're on YouTube, you can definitely go to YouTube.com/signatureincmodels and you know, be able to even listen to that clip to see the excitement around it. We do have a Wake Up Your Wardrobe moment by Miss Apri. So we're gonna tune her in right now, Miss Apri on line two. Hi Apri.
Hi Danielle.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
I'm great. You're gonna give us that Wake Up Your Wardrobe moment. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Okay, well my name's Apri Lemon. And I'm the founder of Real Divas of Large Accessories. And, well, ready or not, you know, the fall season is here. And I'm sure you all seen the rugged and the block colors taking over. I've even seen, you know, like the fetish with the lace and belts and leather. So to accessorize this, we want to go with the layered necklaces.
Mm.
These are definitely the it pieces for the fall.
Wow.
Also, the statement pieces and attention getter necklaces with the chunky bib-like shape.
Right.
They're here to stay. So
and what about those body chains? I remember you accessorized me for an event just recently.
Yes, definitely the body chains as well. They are really hot, really popular, and they're definitely attention getters.
So, Miss Apri, tell us the name of your business and how we can get in contact with you for our accessory needs.
Okay, well, you can visit realdivasalarge.com. You can also give me a call at 443-985-1068. And I'm also a social networker at facebook.com/realdivasalarge.
Okay, thank you for calling in. We appreciate your Wake Up Your Wardrobe moment, and we will surely be in touch. Also, I just want to say really quick, last month we announced the Fashion Talk TV coming this fall, and I'm just happy to say that I'm going to be webcamming it. We're going to be traveling, and I am just shouting out my videographer right now that's in the studio with me, Mr. Marvin. So, and next month's show is going to be all about style, gender. We want to ask yourself, does style even have a gender anymore? Because we have women wearing the trousers and the men dress shirts and, you know, the cardigans, and we have the men wearing skinny jeans. We're going to find out more about that next month. Okay, we're going to go to caller number four. Hello, yeah, you're on Fashion Talk Radio.
Yeah, thank the Lord for waking us up this morning and starting us on our way.
Absolutely.
I'm so glad to hear African-American women, you know, not being so down on their weight,
mm-hmm.
but loving themselves and starting businesses. And I think if every African-American would live out their dream and do what they're supposed to do.
That's right.
You know, because the excuses have to stop. You know, y'all could be females down on yourself. No one wants to talk to me. No one wants to date me. No one wants to do this. But you feel happy about yourself. And I think, you know, just get other young women out there that are plus size, that are fully figured women, that they would love themselves because they see you and they hear you loving yourself.
Right.
I think.
That's right. You know what? We thank you for that word. That was really good encouragement, not only for us, but people that's, you know, listening to you right now. So we do thank you for calling in, Travis. We appreciate you.
Likewise.
All right. Just recently, a couple of weeks ago, we launched a magazine. It's called Girls Glam Magazine. And I'm proud to say that I'm now a magazine editor for this magazine. And it was awesome. It's for a teen and kids magazine for girls ages 5 to 17. It's some really good articles in here. We had Diva Devonna on the cover, youngest fashion superstar out here on the Tyra Show and just traveling the world now. She says she's done over 500 fashion shows, and she's only 11 years old. So you're going to be seeing more about this. If you want to purchase a copy, you can go to girlsglam.com. That's girlsglam.com. And then we also have a fall program that's coming up right now in October that you can actually sign your children up for. So we're just going to do a roundtable real quick in our next 40 seconds.
I'll be writing for Curves Mag.
Yes.
This month.
She's going to, that is a awesome thing. Yeah. She's going to, that's going to be Miss Melinda. Give us your contact information one more time. 10 seconds. Let's go.
Okay. My contact information, you can find me at Facebook at Fashion, P-H-A-T-S-H-I-O-N. Cocky, C-O-K-Y.
And Miss Giovanna?
It's curvista.com, C-U-R-V-Y-S-T-A.com. And my Facebook is Curvista as well as Twitter, Fashion Night Out Plus. FNOPlus.com and FNOPlus for Twitter as well.
And again, this is your host, The Danielle Baker. You can follow me on Twitter at The Danielle B or on Facebook at The Danielle Baker. Thanks for tuning in, and we will see you next month.
Thank you.